Hey guys, in this tutorial we will be making a voxel renderer in Unity. There are two methods to go about this. The first is using the Unity Shuriken particle system, which is CPU based and therefore lacks performance but makes up for it in compatibility and simplicity. The second method is using the VFX graph, which comes with the high definition render pipeline package. This method uses the GPU and supports millions of voxels at a time but is rather complex to implement and isn't compatible with some build settings in Unity. With that said, I decided to do this tutorial with the Shuriken particle system due to its relative ease of use. Getting started, let's create a particle system in the Unity hierarchy by right-clicking and selecting Effects, Particle System. We are presented with the default particle system, which we will now modify to suit our purposes. Firstly, set the start speed to 0. We don't want our voxels to be moving around after all. Then disable Play on Awake and set the max particles to something large like 100,000 for example. Now we can disable Emission and Shape because we will be creating the particles with a script. Next, unfurl the renderer section and change the render mode to mesh and replace the default mesh type with cube. Then change the material to sprites default, since we don't want the fading edges on our cube mesh, and change the sort mode to sort by distance. Change the render alignment to world, and with that, the settings for the particle system are done. Select add component and create a new script. I'm going to name the script voxel renderer. With this script, we are going to set the particles in the particle system. Open the script in your editor of choice and add this line to the top of the script. This will ensure that we always have a particle system in the same game object as this script. We will define three private variables: a particle system, an array of particles, and a bool to check if the particles have been set. We'll also add two public variables: voxel scale to set the size of the individual voxels, and scale to set the total scale of the renderer. This can be replaced with transform.localscale if you don't want to define a variable for it. In our start method, we initialize the particle system, and in our update method, we check if the particles have been set and add them to the particle system if this returns true. We also have to unset the voxels updated flag to be sure the particle system doesn't use up too many resources while not being updated. Finally, we have to create a public method to load voxels into our particle system. This method takes in two arrays, one for the voxel positions and one for the voxel colors. In the body of the method, we'll initialize our voxel array with the length of the passed in positions array. We use the positions array to set the amount of voxels, since both passed in arrays should contain the same amount of elements. If you want, you can do some checking to ensure the length of both passed in arrays are the same. Then we loop through the passed in positions array to assign the positions and colors. The position of the particle will set to the passed position multiplied by the overall scale of our particle system. We set the particle color to the passed in color, and finally the particle size we set to the individual voxel scale. Then we can close the loop. I'll add a little debug line to keep track of the voxel count, and lastly I'll set the voxels updated flag to make sure the particles are added to the particle system. We can test this out by setting some individual particles in the start method. Looks like it works. I want to test the limits of this system, so I'm going to make a loop to generate random particles. I'll start with 10,000 voxels to see how the system handles them. Seems to be doing fine. How about 100,000? Here's where it breaks down, at least in the editor. The frame rate will increase if I build a project. For a last little showcase, I downloaded a point cloud of a vertebra as an ASC file and wrote a small function to add this point cloud to my voxel renderer. This file consists of 125,000 colored points and understandably makes the editor upset. I cut the points in half and the frame rate is much higher now. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned something new. If you want to stick around for future videos, please consider subscribing, and a like is always appreciated. With that said, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video.